This video is going to be my first look at the Niner Air 9 RDO. Like other bikes that I reviewed, the first video that I put out is just one showing the bike up close in a way that you probably can't see on a website, talking about the components, talking about the build, before I've gotten any miles on it. Unlike other bikes that I reviewed, this is actually not mine. This is my son's bike. I'm not going to really rehash why I got the bike. I'll put a video in the description below where I got him the bike, but the long and short of it is, most of the trails around our house are cross-country trails. He has an enduro bike. I wanted him to get more into cross-country riding, and slugging a slack heavy enduro bike around cross-country trails is probably not the best way to enjoy cross-country. So we're getting him going on this Niner Air 9. So this Air 9 has actually not seen trail time yet. We got the bike about a month and a half ago and went on a trip to North Carolina where my son fractured his wrist. Maybe I'll drop that video in the description below as well, but he's still recovering, so he's not able to ride just yet. It's probably going to be another week. So this bike has not seen any dirt yet, so it's really clean. Everyone always asks about the weight, so let's go ahead and get that out of the way. This bike weighs 23.5 pounds as it's set up with Shimano pedals. So these are just some older Shimano XT pedals. And we've got a couple water bottle cages on it, some Dawn to Dusk water bottle cages. These are actually pretty sweet cages that were given to me to review, and we're gonna try them on this bike. So this is the 3-star build, and between the time that I got this bike and now that I'm shooting this video, Niner have changed the specs a little bit on the 3-star build. So this is a Shimano XT build. The main difference between the current 3-star build is the fact that the new 3-star build is a GX build. It also comes with Schwalbe tires instead of Maxxis. So I actually really like this build. My son really likes Shimano brakes, likes Shimano shifters, and I love Maxxis tires. So I'm kind of glad we got the bike when we did. However, that being said, the 3-star build, whether it's GX or Shimano XT, is probably the best value in this lineup. The 4-star build, you go up a little bit on the wheel set. The current 4-star build is Shimano XT, and it's got a DT Swiss 1700 wheel set as opposed to the 1900. But let's take a look at this bike like it is. With this bike being the Air 9 RDO, that means it's carbon as opposed to the regular Air 9. That's an alloy frame. Now, I've owned an Air 9 RDO in the past, and the frame is just incredibly responsive. And we'll follow this video up with some ride videos after my son gets some miles on it. I'll let him report back how he likes this bike compared to his enduro bike. But, you know, from past experience, I love the way these hardtails corner. You can just snap it back and forth. It almost pops out of a corner and pops into the next corner. So I think he's really gonna like that aspect. This bike comes with a Fox StepCast 100 millimeter travel fork, and being the StepCast means that it's going to be very light. This Fox fork has 32 millimeter stanchion tubes, which is a really good spec. It keeps the fork pretty light. Anything more than 100 millimeters of travel, I would recommend 34 millimeter stanchion tubes just to increase the stiffness because you've got more leverage on it. But again, this is a 32. It's also the Performance Series, and that means it does not have the Kashima coating. And that's one of the main differences between a Niner 3-star build and a 4-star build. Typically the 4-star build will come with a factory Fox fork as opposed to the Performance, and the factory has the Kashima coating. Of course, the front fork is a through axle with a quick release. Because this bike is more of a race-focused bike, it comes with a fork with a remote lockout. Now, typically when I choose a fork, even for cross-country racing, I don't choose the remote lockout. I don't really lock out my fork that often. I like the fact that non-remote lockout forks are a little bit simpler. However, setting this up was really easy. I mean, it was so easy to run the cable through here. So, you know, it's probably gonna pay off for my son. I mean, I think he likes sprinting. He's got really good fast twitch muscles. So being able to lock out the fork for a sprint can really have its advantages. So this is the lever on the bar, and to lock it out, you just push that button, and then to unlock it, just hit the smaller button. Since I mentioned the quick release on the front, the rear also has a quick release, and it's just the kind, it's a DT Swiss, so you just pull that out, rotate it where you want it, and then when you push it back in, it will engage, and that way you can use it as a quick release. And the rear axle is a Boost 148 on this bike. Let's take a look at the cockpit. So it comes with a Niner carbon seat post. and a Niner saddle. Saddles are probably the most personal choice on a bike, but the Niner saddles that come on their bikes are pretty decent. The handlebar is a Niner flat top, so it's a totally flat bar, and it is 780 wide. My son's gonna shorten this. He's gonna go down to 760, see if he likes that. He likes his bars a little bit shorter than I do. If it were me, I'd probably keep it at 780. And I believe this is a carbon bar. I mean, it looks carbon. It's kind of hard to tell, and it does not say on the website, but just looking at the details of the bar, it appears to me to be carbon. Even when I tap on it, it's kind of hard to tell if it's carbon or aluminum, but I'm gonna go with carbon. And the stem is a Niner alloy stem. It is 90 millimeters, so a little bit longer than what you'd run on a trail bike. Most trail bikes are around 50, but being that this is a more cross-country focused bike, this is a 90 millimeter stem. Before I show the wheels and the drivetrain, I just want to mention the sizing. So he went with a large. My son is a little under 6 feet tall. You can go on Niner's website and they will show you a chart for the different sizes. Niners tend to run a little bit larger. Now I'm a little over 5'8 and I run a medium, but I just want to throw in the size there because that's a pretty typical question that gets asked when I review a bike. All right, now looking at the drivetrain. So the crankset is a race face turbine. It's got 175 crank arms and it is a narrow wide chain ring. So of course you don't need a front derailleur or any kind of chain guide. And this is a 32 tooth front chain ring. Bottom bracket is a press fit bottom bracket and it comes with a race face bottom bracket. Rear derailleur is a Shimano XT. Again, this is the older 3-star build, so the newer 3-star builds are gonna come with the GX rear derailleur. And this has the newer Shimano 12-speed cassette, so it goes from a 10 up to a 51 tooth. Their rear shifter is also Shimano XT. And I wanna go ahead and mention here that cable routing on this bike was really easy. The rear shifter goes into the left side of the frame on the down tube, and it runs full cable all the way through the frame and then stays internal all the way to the back of the chainstay. And the rear brake cable is external, and I've got bikes with internal brake cables and external. I'm fairly neutral. Having it external makes it a whole lot easier to work on, especially if you have to change the brake. So there's pluses and minuses, but it's still a pretty clean routing. So coming underneath the bottom bracket and then just coming up inside the chainstay. You do have a port on the right side of the down tube in case you wanted to run a dropper post. So you would just bring it in there, run it all the way through the frame. I don't think we'll put a dropper post on this bike. For cross country around here, you simply just don't need it. And not having the additional weight and complexity is worth just learning how to corner without a dropper seat post. This bike comes with Shimano XT brakes. And I'll go ahead and throw in my comparison here between XT and SRAM, because as far as components, the biggest difference to me in the field of components is always the brakes. So Shimano brakes have a real grabby feel, so they have a lot of initial bite, a little bit less modulation through the stroke, where SRAM brakes have less initial grab, less initial bite, but they have a little bit better modulation. And all of my bikes currently, except for one, have SRAM brakes. And I actually prefer Shimano. I say this all the time, but I might as well say it again. I prefer working on Shimano in terms of not having to worry about DOT fluid. You know, Shimano use mineral oil. Now, the one negative thing for me for Shimano brakes are these cooling fins. So they kind of rattle around a little bit noisy. Now, I haven't done a lot of research on this, but I would imagine that the reason Shimano typically uses these is that mineral oil inside the brakes can heat up a little bit more than DOT fluid. Put in the comments below if you know that. Again, that's just kind of my gut feeling on that. For brake rotors, you've got a 180 in the front and a 160 rear rotor, which is a pretty common combination for a cross-country race bike. Now, these are Shimano center lock. I just want to mention that. Some people have preferences. I actually prefer 6-bolt rotors just because they're a little bit more standard now. If I'm swapping wheels around, I typically will have wheels that are 6-bolt, but again, just want to throw that in there. And then wrapping up this review with the wheels and the tires. So this bike comes with a set of DT Swiss 1900 wheels. Even the newer 3-star build comes with the DT Swiss 1900s. And I've actually been really impressed with these wheels. I've got these on a couple bikes that are in my fleet right now. And this is probably the best alloy wheel set, both this and the 1700 DT Swiss wheels. And I'll get my son's feedback on these wheels. He's got Stan's Flow on his Enduro bike. But again, these are pretty lightweight wheel set, and they're also pretty laterally stiff for an alloy wheel set. Like I said before, I'm a Maxxis tire fan, and I love the tire combination that comes on this particular bike. Now, like I said at the beginning of the video, the newer 3-star build comes with Schwalbe tires. I've used Schwalbe in the past. I like those too. I just like Maxxis a little bit better. So it's got the Recon on the front. It's a 2.4 in the front. So the Recon has a little bit more grip than the Recon Race. So again, I like this combination because especially around here, we've got a lot of cornering. You're constantly cornering, and having some extra grip in the front, I think my son is really gonna like that. In the back is a Recon Race, so still some pretty good cornering knobs. It's just got lower center knobs for less rolling resistance. So that's an overview of the Niner Air 9 RDO Hardtail Cross Country Race Bike. I'm actually really stoked to get my son out on the trail on this bike to see how he likes it, especially again after riding a pretty heavy and slack enduro bike for a couple years. As always, questions or comments that you have, drop those below. Thanks for watching.